Good morning, everybody. My name is Randy St. Clair, and we're out here at Baylands Park in Sunnyvale, California, with the VTOL Explorer. That's this guy right here. Now, the VTOL Explorer is a kitbash, or a modified version of the Flight Test Explorer. That's their, I guess you'd call it a trainer plane that is made to allow users to explore different design options. And in this particular case, the design option we're exploring is vertical takeoff and landing. So this aircraft has, well, it's pretty much stock except for the wing, and mostly these two motor pods right here, which basically make it a quad and an airplane at the same time. So this is all built pretty much with stock flight test gear. This is the standard flight test power pack for the forward thrust motor. We've got the standard flight test power packs for the quad. And by the way, there's going to be detailed instructions on how to build this for anyone who wants to, with all the parts lists and everything like that. So it's just it's a vertical takeoff and landing airplane. So let me show you some more things about it here. So we'll take the nose off. And this is the standard nose for the flight test design, which is really nice because it gives us lots of room to get in there for the batteries and so on. And we added this little shelf right here, and this is the flight controller. It's a standard KK2 hardware, very inexpensive, under $20. But it's running a custom firmware. It's called the Open Aero VTOL firmware, which has all the features necessary to fly a VTOL aircraft, and even more than a VTOL aircraft, to fly all kinds of aircraft. It has two flight modes, hover mode and forward flight, although those could be used for any two things you wanted, but in this case that's exactly what we're going to use them for. Now, I've actually provided two sets of parameters so we can set it up in two different ways. I call it the very easy mode and the easy mode. So there is no hard mode with this aircraft. It is super easy to fly. And matter of fact, this first flight we'll be doing this morning will be in the very easy mode. And what I mean by that is it's full auto level in hover, so it'll basically hover all by itself. And then full auto level in forward flight, so that it's what I call a stick to bank angle mode, meaning if you release the stick and let it go to neutral, the airplane will immediately go back to level. So this is the kind of mode that you'd be comfortable giving any beginner. And it's also a very nice mode for any kind of FPV or first person view type operation. Okay, so this is a 3.3 amp hour Turnigy Nanotech battery. That's what we're going to be using. And it's always a good idea to check the battery voltage, which says it's 95%, so we're good to go. I'm going to go ahead and install it in the aircraft. So I like to just plug it in right here into the plug. And you notice I let it just sit steady for a moment while it was powering up the flight controller. And now I'm going to go ahead and put it in place here. I'll just install it right there on the Velcro. Nothing fancy, nothing difficult. And then we'll put the nose on. Oh, and I forgot to turn the transmitter on. We should really do that first, but it's okay because it's safe. As long as the transmitter's off, the motors won't run. So we'll go ahead and put the nose on. Make sure everything's inside where it belongs. And we are ready to fly. Well, here we go, first flight of the morning. So let's start by arming the flight controller. We'll move the stick down and in, and then test the controls here. Using a very small amount of power, and with up elevator, I can hear the difference, and left and right, you can actually rock the plane back and forth. So yeah, we're good to go. So let's go ahead and just take off. So I really haven't even touched the sticks, hardly. We got a little bit of wind this morning, 2 or 3 miles an hour. So I'm going to go ahead and switch into slow forward flight mode. And you'll notice the forward thrust motor just started running. Now it's running slowly, but I'm only managing one throttle stick, not two. Now you may notice that little bit of a warbling sound. That's basically the beat frequency of the motors and the propellers interacting with the motor pods, but it's not a problem. It's a little louder than I would like, but it's not a problem. So let's go ahead and do a transition into full forward flight. Now I'm just gonna flip the switch and let it do it all by itself here. I am hands off the sticks right now. I have not touched the stick the entire time. It is flying by itself. And now I'm gonna take over because I need to turn it eventually. But that's all I'm doing is just turning it. Now I'm flying it, in this case that turn was just ailerons only. I'm not even needing to use rudder because I have a full automatic turn coordination mode built into the flight controller at this time. So let's go ahead and take it up high, relatively high. Because one of the things I want to show you is I want to show you that it can glide and that it's still an airplane. Well, that's probably high enough for this purpose. So what I'm going to do is cut the throttle. And now we're a glider. And while we're a glider, I'm going to go ahead and switch into hover mode. So even though right now there's no power at all, I'm in hover mode and I'm just nicely gliding down. No big deal. And what I want to show you is that when the time is right, I will go ahead and power up. And we'll make that now, I guess. And so I immediately have full control in a hover mode, even though I'm still going fairly fast. So part of the fun with these things is being able to do, you know, make it look like you know what you're doing. So, now that was full left rudder. Let's try that again with full right. And you can see the wind pushing me a little bit. And I haven't done a controls test yet for you, so let's go ahead and demonstrate. This is roll, very soft. And this is pitch, also very soft. And even though we've got a 2 or 3 mile an hour wind here pushing us backwards, you notice the airplane can actually handle it and can actually go forward. Even though we're still in hover mode, we can go forward at a pretty reasonable pace. And of course, if we have more wind or we need to fly faster, then we switch back into slow forward flight. And now you can see the forward thrust motor is kicked on again. But we can still hover in this mode, which I will now demonstrate. And the only thing is I just need to hover a little bit nose high. But of course, if there's any wind, now I can push the nose down just a little and immediately penetrate into the wind. So unlike a lot of VTOLs, this one handles wind with ease. So let's do another transition. Maybe we'll do this one sideways so you can see it better. So I'm going to turn it around here. And we'll do it sideways to the camera, starting now. And this is another hands-off transition. And we're an airplane. Now I can't do any aerobatics in this particular mode because I'm in the you might call it the beginner mode or the very easy mode. And it won't let me. And that's intentional. However, I can easily program it in a different mode and I will in just a bit. So for example, this is full left aileron. That's all it will do is it go on its side like that. And full up elevator. So now I'm holding full up elevator, just continuously holding it. And that's all it does. And of course, the fun one is full down elevator. So let me get just a little bit of altitude before I do that. I'll turn it around and then we'll do full down. Okay, here's full down. That's all it does. Goes to about a 45 degree angle and it won't go any farther. So that's just because of the way the flight controller is programmed. So let's do one more approach and then landing, and then we'll change the control mode and try it again. So this time I'm going to do a transition up high, which I just did. So the lift motors are running, and now I just back off the throttle to let it descend, otherwise it won't come down. But it's very easy to fly. It's just an airplane in all of these different modes. You don't have to really worry about what mode you're in. You just fly it. Now you may notice as I get slow, I have to give it a little more power. And that's just the nature of the physics. But it really is easy to fly. And there's the landing. So now I'll just disarm by moving the sticks down into the to the outside, down and out as I call it. And now it's disarmed and the motors don't run no matter what I do with the power. That's it. So we're back. I've made a little bit of a change to the programming. We're now in the easy mode as opposed to the very easy mode. And what that means is that we don't have auto level in forward flight. It's still very easy, trust me. So here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna go ahead and arm and take off just like before. But this time we're gonna do some very, very mild aerobatics to the extent that this kind of a plane can do those kind of mild aerobatics. So here we go. We'll go straight into slow forward flight just because. And then we'll go ahead and go into fast forward flight. And away it goes. Just like before. So let's go ahead and climb up a little bit before we do what this thing does. Now I'm not claiming that it's an aerobatic airplane by any stretch of the imagination. I mean, it should be fairly obvious that it's basically a trainer. So let's start with your good old basic loop. Just to show that it can do it. And let's see, we'll do a roll here. Nice little slow kind of a roll. And now we're gonna stretch it just a little bit because like I said, it's not an aerobatic plane, but it will fly inverted. And well, let me turn it around here. And now I'm not saying it'll fly well inverted or anything, but it will do it. And I'm losing altitude here. So that's enough of that. You notice how the lift propellers actually start spinning. But when we're upright, they don't spin, and that's because their angle is optimized for minimum drag in the upright position. It's really not meant to fly inverted, obviously. So let's see, what else can we do? The rudder is quite powerful, especially with the prop wash directly over the rudder the way it is. Oh, that was a pretty sloppy stall turn. That's a little better. Now we're going to demonstrate that, you know, I need better, more practice as a pilot. But anyway, like I said, it's not exactly an aerobatic plane. But just so you know that it can do these things. All right, so let's go ahead and make our reverse transition now. I went straight to hover mode just for the heck of it. And we'll bring it in just like before. Now part of the fun with these things is letting your guests know that you have full control and that, you know, that you can be smooth about it. Of course, and then when they see you put it down like a feather, they think you know what you're doing. So I'm disarming now. With the sticks down and out. And now it's safe because I'm raising the throttle and nothing's happening. And that's the VTOL Explorer.